So during the Krebs cycle, the acetyl-CoA here, the carbon molecules are reduced and also H+ ions are reduced in successive reaction. Then here the energy is released in the form of NADH+ and H+, and the CO2 also resulted here. So in the presence of oxygen only, they are entered into the Krebs cycle. So what are the steps involved into the Krebs cycle? We see. So coming to the Krebs cycle, just I am writing here the intermediate reaction. What is that? From pyruvic acid. So pyruvic acid to acetyl-CoA production. So during this intermediate reaction, so what are the compounds are released here? The NAD is coenzyme, so NAD plus, NADH plus H+ is released, and the CO2 is released here, and here the required the cofactors and coenzymes are Mg+2 ions and lipoic acid and thymine pyrophosphate. So here, what is the reaction? It is oxidative decarboxylation reaction. Decarboxylation. What is the enzyme involved here? The involved enzyme is pyruvic dehydrogenase. Dehydrogenase enzyme. Then the acetyl-CoA is released. So here the CoA also needed for production of acetyl-CoA. Then this reaction is, the next reaction is condensation reaction. So the condensation reaction means here the acetyl-CoA is condensed with oxaloacetic acid. So the acetyl-CoA is 2-carbon molecule, and when it is condensed with OAA oxaloacetic acid, 4-carbon consisting molecule, so then it turned into citric acid. Here it is a 6-carbon compound, the first formed compound in Krebs cycle, that is called citric acid. So hence this cycle is said as citric acid cycle. Citric acid cycle. Why it is citric acid cycle? The first stable formed compound is citric acid during the Krebs cycle. So this reaction is mediated by the enzyme citric synthetase. So what is the work of synthetase enzyme? To construction, to synthesis. So here the citric acid is synthesized here. And the next following reaction is to produce isocitric acid and cis-aconitic acid. Cis-aconitic acid. So these all are 6C carbon consisting molecule. So here the working enzyme is aconitase. Aconitase. Next is here alpha ketoglutaric acid production. Alpha ketoglutaric acid production. So here how the alpha ketoglutaric acid is produced means here by loss of 1-carbon dioxide molecule, here the cis aconitic acid is converted into alpha ketoglutaric acid, and here 1 NAD is produce 1 NADHH+. It means this reaction is called again oxidative decarboxylation reaction. Decarboxylation reaction. You see here, in the respiration, aerobic respiration, so the first oxidative decarboxylation reaction conducted between the pyruvic acid to acetyl-CoA production. Another, it means second oxidative decarboxylation reaction carried out between the cis aconitic acid to alpha keto glutaric acid. So during the formation of alpha keto glutaric acid, here the one carbon dioxide molecule is released and one NADH2 is reduced. And so you see here, this is the intermediate compound. The intermediate compound can able to entry in the synthesis of amino acids. Amino acid synthesis. It means they may involve further reactions of Krebs cycle, or sometimes it involved into the amino acid synthesis. Then alpha-ketoglutaric acid to succinyl-CoA.